Ladies and gentlemen, behold, 400 cubic inches of pure Pontiac excitement. Today, we are going to tear this sucker open and find out why it decided to screw me over.
Come out one piece or it snap?
Oh, it's there.
Wow. Well, now we just gotta do that several more times.
Yeah.
I'll give it a shot. Oh, the old candle wax trick, eh?
Yeah.
That's supposed to be able to penetrate into the threads, is that it?
Yeah.
Shit. Trying the old shock treatment trick. Yeah. All right, so this is off. Yeah, and quite obviously, and this is all there was left of the gasket. Pretty crappy.
Yeah.
And, like you said, broken off flush there. That's not so bad. We could drill that out. I don't know what the fuck we're going to do with that one. That one's been broken since I got the car. Yeah, well, I guess let's do the other side and...
Yeah.
See how many more broken bolts we can generate.
Yeah, that's the least of the engine's problems.
Yeah, exactly. Here we go. Oh, you got the... Oh, those two were finger tight, you said? Those
one are, was. There was one missing.
Oh, it's probably snapped off in there. So we've only got three left.
Yeah.
Nice. We only got this one broken off one that's been there since forever, I guess.
Yeah.
Not bad. Next stop, intake manifold. A good look at the way things look before we go fucking around with it. See-through intake manifold. See how much garbage we find under here.
Yeah, right.
I can see plenty of leaves already. I didn't even know that was like that. Otherwise, I would have attempted to clean that out, you know.
Yeah.
Before I drove the car. All right, we got all the bolts out. Bolts out here. All the stuff that was in the way. The EGR valve. A couple of brackets. Bracket here. Interesting. There's a long bolt that goes straight through here into here. This appears to be... just sort of sits in there like into a little cup, so it should pull back and up and out. So. There you go. No, it's not, it doesn't go into like a ledge like you showed in that picture. It just mates right up against it. How the hell does that make a seal?
It's just that all the machine surface.
General Motors in the 1970s? I don't know. Didn't leak though.
No, definitely did not. Right. Well, actually, it did. Wasn't there a little pull here?
Oh, you're right. That's right, yeah. But that it wasn't like that when I was ever driving the car. Yeah. It was after the car sat for a few weeks. Feels like something's holding me down in the front. Is this a piece of gasket or something? It feels springy.
Yeah, there's something under there. Probably like with the tube here. PCB valve's holding it.
Oh. Ah.
Wow.
Oh. Oh my god. Oh.
Looks like a manifold. Ah. Woo, look at this. Oh, nice. There's like a nice deep crud catching pocket. Great. Now I think time to get the shop back. How deep does this go? Wow, it's like a couple inches deep. What a stupid idea. Well, I mean, it's like a hole. I mean, the mice must have loved this. Wish I'd have known that that was an existent place. I'd have vacuumed it out. Wonderful. Oh, how long was this sitting here? So this is only held on, it appears, by these two bolts.
That's a nice parts tray.
Yeah.
I just assumed that was RTV. Though.
It looks like it was at one point.
Yeah, a long time ago.
Yeah. It's nice and clean in there.
Yeah.
A lot cleaner looking than the inside of my Buick when we did that gaskets a couple years ago.
Some balls of sludge in here.
Oh, yeah.
No rollers on this one, huh?
Nope.
Do they have an upgrade for that?
Maybe. Probably. Okay, valve cover is off. This is the side with the damage. It's, Dave, which cylinder? Is it this one? Or this one? Or both? Both kind of, right? These two, okay. Yeah, so we're about to find out what's what. So 9 bolts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Unless this is a bolt as well, then that'd be 10. Yeah, this is probably one. Okay, all the head bolts are off. Okay, here we go. Ready?
Big fucking valve.
Yeah. Whew. It looks all right. Probably should have found a place to put it first. God. All right, I guess we'll get a light and move this thing around, and because I can't see anything here. Yeah. Well, let's get the other head off. I guess we're gonna need to turn this motor. Okay, so, you know, we took off the head on the side that we knew we had a problem with. And, you know, the
blood or something.
Yeah. So then we said, well, you know, we got to get these down a little bit farther. Because when Dave put the scope in here, he saw the damage, I think, was on this cylinder somewhere in here.
Somewhere in here.
Yeah. However, once we took the head off of this side, we found all this stuff in... every cylinder, yes it is. Or no, wait. Is this steel? Ah, it's steel. It's steel. I thought it was aluminum. All right. Look at that there. Gasket. That's just some crud from the gasket.
This wall looks okay.
Wow, looks, you know, undamaged, shiny.
Yeah.
All right. I don't see anything just yet. Maybe it was this one? Steel up this way. So, the piston ring theory again?
That's what the picture made it look like. It was that broken rings.
Yeah.
But now I'm not seeing
it. I'm not even seeing the damage we saw with the scope.
I know.
So what the hell were we looking at?
We just have to pull the pistons out and look.
Yeah. All right.